Welcome back to Mobile Electronic Diagnostic. Today we have 528i BMW 2012. The customer brought this car here and kind of lights are inside and a lot of trouble. We don't know, but he said that the car is shut off while he's driving, and we say we're going to diagnose the car for you. He said no, he know what the problem is, the transmission causing to shut down. So I say, okay, if you know the problem, there is no need to diagnose. But after we check the car, they change the belt, there is some light inside here. We just want to go inside and diagnose this car and to be sure that what's going on, what happened. We are using the dealer tools, and there is a noise in the engine. That noise is still there? The noise is gone. Yeah, it could be just an air, you know, like those. The belt, yeah, okay. You have a noise, and then when they change the oil, that light is gone after rev it a little bit. But let's diagnose the car and see what light is there, what we have, and what we need to do. As usual, we're using ISTA-A diagnosis with Actia interface. I'm gonna move this one here for a little bit so that we can see the dashboard. I'm gonna start the car. I wanna see what light are there. Check engine light is there. Airbag light is gone, nothing. We don't have, we have only check engine light, which is good news. There is no noise there. Okay, let's see what is in a data, in a diagnostic. As usual, we're gonna use ISTA-A. Raymond, I don't hear nothing. Beautiful.
No, he does not.
That chichichi under it look like a muffler touching.
Yeah, that's inside the muffler.
No, that's nothing. So let me go. Now I'm gonna diagnose it. I'm gonna run a complete test in this car. And you see there is nothing.
No, it's not showing up here. Over there.
What is showing here?
It was showing that charging. Maybe.
No, just because maybe.
Wait, I forget the.
No, did you start with the belt out?
Yeah, we started with the belt out.
Okay, if
the
car, if it's engine running and the belt is not hooked up,
yeah,
it will give you a charging problem.
That's what I'm saying. That's why I
tell Mamu. There is no problem in the car. So the guy say, why my light is on? Because you start the car with the belt on, because you want to listen to the noise.
You need to
listen to the noise of the engine. You disconnect
the belt
as to tension. So when you disconnect the belt, the engine is running, but the computer is not seeing charging system. That's why the message come here. We have a problem here. Some people have to be patient to see the result.
Yeah.
You know, like it is. So now I'm gonna go. Still, I will diagnose the whole car. I will run a complete test and to see why the check engine light is on. And I'm sure that the check engine light was on when he brought the car in, because when he said the transmission,
when he said transmission
have a problem,
I get called also for oxygen sensor.
Okay, so that's good. So we have no problem. This car running like a baby, and because they have no. There is no oil in the system. It can create that problem.
Yeah.
Mamu changed the oil, right?
Yeah, it was coming from inside the car engine.
Oil leaking out from there?
No, the noise was.
Yeah, because of the there is no oil.
Oil
is no good.
Yeah.
You need a good oil with a good viscosity oil. So let me try to check this car, run a complete test with the dealer tools, which we're using it here. And we see what's going on. Those car, if the oil is no good, it will create problem. It can even shut down the car while the car is running. If the transmission, this is F10 series. Okay, I see the car information, everything here. And then I will look for start vehicle test.
Charging system.
You don't have no charging system problem, because while you are testing the noise in the car, and you see this car have like almost all the modules have codes. Those are history codes. Engine also, DME also have a code. The only place that is green in this car is the electronic fuel pump control module and CIC. But all the other, they have general code. This is because the dealer, he will look if there is any code around. And we have just to reset it, reset those codes and the case closed. But the engine have a code because the check engine light is on.
Yeah.
But I'm running a complete test to see what's going on. This is where I was trying to diagnose it for him to see what caused it. He said, no, my car have a problem, transmission problem. But this car running, wow. This car sounds so beautiful. Smooth. But I really appreciate that if you do any job, you're supposed to test the car, drive it, let the car warm up, oil go up. Don't give the customer the car just right away like that. Because sometimes you have to drive it, test it, be sure everything is okay.
Yeah, because he's getting to argument.
Yeah, you don't need that one. Okay, I have 98 codes that have nothing to do with the mechanical noise. Mechanical noise is oil only. And you have to give time to the engine to lubricate itself. That's normal. You see, you have those valves and pressure on those rocker, you know, like those, like a piston kind of, what they call cylinder, you know, like it have a, like a hydraulic lifters. You have to give some time to fill out oil. Okay, thank you. Oh, now we have 100 volts. Let me display all these volts. You know those power window? They tinted, they did not initialize it. This is not our problem. I'm not gonna reset any codes here unless the engine, or I can reset it for him. Mixture control fuel yard system is two-lean, check engine light, air pressure control, pulsability. You have misfires. You know, a couple of misfires, cylinder misfire, fuel tank, ventilation, purge, differential pressure sensor, engine coolant, pre-reduced operation, alternator mechanical malfunction. You see alternator mechanical malfunction? VTG under voltage, gearbox. Wow. Battery voltage was 12 volt. Okay. Guys, this is very nice information. We can talk about this for all year, you know? This control under voltage, but brake pad wear front axle, also you have to change it. Electronic under voltage. Outside mirror, air conditioning compressor clutch off. Deactivation terminal, you know, like a lot of items here. Battery was weak, yes. Right fuel level sensor. Okay, I'm gonna take this thing out. I'm gonna reset the whole car.
Okay.
Reset everything for him because a lot of delete fault memory. I have 100 fault. You can take this car for drive any place you want.
Yeah.
Yes. I'm gonna do all the. Mahmoud, you work. Good morning. You're working on the car. You change oil. You put a oil on it. You start the car. Don't give the customer the car till at least you wait. And you know, like those kind of cars, the hydraulic lifters and oil have to recirculate all over. You understand? Mm-hmm. He is sitting in the car here, and you do the work. You start the car. The engine noise change. He will get. You know, he go crazy.
No, but he can't because of that noise.
You see. Okay. So now I reset everything from 100 codes. I have only 5 codes, which is sliding visor, not normalized, and SHD not normalized. Can Ford, those are other codes that in the car. We don't have to worry about it. I'm gonna start the car, check engine light is gonna go. I don't have no code at all. Encore, after I reset everything, the car is running so beautiful. It's smooth, BMW. When you fix a car like this, try always to do your test, give time, drive it, warm up the car, let the oil lubricate itself. and then you take it from there. Thank you for watching Mobile Electronic. Please subscribe, share, and like. This is Muhammad Harun Idris.